Trump and Biden want to fight each other again in the 2020 election, but the public would prefer to see anyone other than these two candidates going at it. You know, I got to tell you something. I looked at this and I said, okay, here's the way. It's a tired old man fighting dementia versus the sociopath with no moral compass. That does not bring a warm and fuzzy feeling to me when I'm saying those are the two candidates that we're going to be talking about. You know, it's almost a gag reflex when I think about it.
Well, you know, excuse me, I think it was back in 2014, you and I were doing segments, because in 2014, it looked like we were going to have Hillary Clinton versus Jeb Bush. So we had talked about another Clinton versus Bush. Everything is just repeating itself. But now this is even worse. Mm. America had Trump for 4 years. They said, my God, at the end of it, we're sick of this. They've had Biden for 15 and a half months, and they're already saying, oh my God, we're sick of this. So to put these two back up there, which unfortunately looks like that is what's going to happen.
I just can't even.
The numbers are astounding, though. It's about 60, 65% of Americans say, I would support a third party candidate if these are the two guys that you give me to choose from. And that's actually a wonderful opportunity for anybody that's not, you know, horrible like these guys to jump in and possibly take this election and maybe put us on a different path, a better path, breaking the duopoly.
Just take us out of where we are right now. So on the Democratic side, it looks like the Democrats are desperate to hold on to what they remember, even though it's not quite accurate. They remember is the golden Clinton years before he completely lost his moral compass. And on the Republicans, they're so angry. They're so tired of woke and, you know, what they call snowflake politics. And they're just saying, we would put Rasputin up if we can just get past this. So it's this, they believe, both sides believe, not to a big majority, but certainly a significant majority, say that this is a good idea. Yeah. You know, this is a good idea. Let's run Biden against Trump. I can't even comprehend that that's the way people are thinking.
Well, and the Democrats are making the same mistake that Hillary Clinton made in 2016, because their camp said, oh, we definitely want to go against Trump. He's so easy. He's so beatable. And now Biden's people are out there telling the media, oh man, we would love for Trump to be the person we go up against. No, you wouldn't. Right now, election held today, Trump's beaten Biden by, I think, 6 points.
Yeah, 6 or 7 points.
And Trump's people know that.
Yeah.
And that's the scary part
for
them.
But isn't it bothersome that they're willing to say, yeah, we're going to let you run again, knowing what we went through, and knowing that we're going to take advantage of the fact that this is what Biden's facing. Inflation. He's facing an economy that is in the tank. If you take a look at the GDP, it's in the tank. Stock market's in the tank. You've got a recession right around the corner that's going to time itself right into the midterms. And you've got the Dems believing that gender rights or abortion issues or unisex bathrooms are what mothers, you know, voters care about. Biden has lost the woman at home taking care of a family. He's lost her. Because they're going to the store, there's nothing. It looks like Moscow, 1965, in some places around this country, where the shelves are empty. There's not enough baby formula even to take care of their children. They look at prices that have gone up 40% on just items like bread and milk. And Biden seems to think, well, we can get past all that by talking about the standard woke issues. He's dead in the water.
Right.
And unfortunately, this crazy man, Trump, could actually beat him.
Well, he absolutely could. And unfortunately, the Biden, you know, administration came out recently, told the media, our plan is to make the midterms all about Trump, about how bad Trump is.
Is that a good idea?
Absolutely. Look, everybody that's not, you know, hoarding MAGA gear in their closet, everybody knows how bad Trump was. You don't have to go out there and say it every day. What they want to know is, listen, I can't afford groceries. And hey, guess what? When I can't afford them, sometimes they're not there. That is a thing that happens. I know liberals, you know, they do get mad when you say that, oh, the shelves are empty. No, we've experienced that in our local grocery store.
Of course.
There's
somebody,
no chicken for months.
I don't know where these folks are that sound, Pap, this is no problem. You're making that up. You're talking like a right-wing nut.
I hate
to hear that kind of stupidity.
Right. It's a thing that does happen. And the baby formula is obviously a big issue.
How about this? There's still 20% of voters who say, yeah, the economy is really good. Where in the hell do they live? I mean, honestly, where are 55% say Biden is the cause of a failed economy. That's the headline right there. 55% say Biden, whether it's true or not, whether it's holdover from Trump, it doesn't make any difference. They hang it around Biden's neck.
Right.
And Biden is incapable of defending himself at this point. If it's not on a teleprompter, it's word salad. And that's what you'd have in debates. It would look like word salad versus this sociopathic babble. That's what the debate would look like.
Right. And look, is Biden the reason the prices are up right now? Personally, I don't think he is responsible for this.
I don't think he is either.
Right. He's not out there saying gas companies raise the price of gas. That's beyond his control, but he is the president.
Right.
And so, yes, it does fall at his feet.
Most economists that look at it, it's much more complicated than Biden. It really is. You're coming out of COVID. You've got people that aren't even back to work yet. You've got part of the economy where they've stopped working. They're going home. I don't need to work anymore. I've got something else I'm going to do. So you've got all this stuff happening, but 55% of the American public are saying it's Biden's fault.
Right.
And the terrible thing about it is he can't seem to defend himself. He's putting Kamala Harris out there to defend him. When you talk about psychobabble, listen to that woman sometime trying to defend the president. It's useless.